Hello guys, here we will be dealing with the previous year gate questions of 2018 of the subject power system. The first question comes here is, here we consider a lossy transmission line with line voltages V1 and V2 as sending and receiving end voltages. Z and X here, Z and X are the series impedance and the reactance of transmission line. We need to find the value of steady state stability limit of this transmission line. Now see, steady state stability limit, what means here is the maximum value of power flow that is possible in line with steady state condition prevailing. But here we have to calculate this steady state stability limit considering lossy transmission line here. This is given lossy in the question. So, as two different types of impedances and reactances are given, we will consider each case separately. See, when we are considering only series impedance, this series impedance, in that case what will happen is we will find the value of power flow as it will be equal to V1 V2 by Z cos theta minus delta minus V2 square by Z cos theta. Now for calculating steady state stability limit, as I told you that it is the maximum power flow possible in a transmission line. So in this case, maximum power flow P max will occur when this theta becomes equal to delta. So when theta gets equal to delta, what happens here? The maximum value of power value will be V1 V2 by Z cos theta minus delta. Since both are equal, this will be equal to 0 degree and cos 0 will be equal to 1. So this will be minus here V2 square by Z cos delta. As I told you, in case of maximum power transfer, theta gets equal to delta. Next, we will consider the value of series reactance X only. Okay. Now, when we consider the value of series reactance X only, what happens is, when Z becomes equal to X, then theta becomes equal to 90 degree. So, in that case, the value of power flow P will be equal to, this is the case of series reactance X. So the power flow will be equal to V1 V2 by X cos 90 minus delta minus V2 square by X cos 90. As cos 90 is 0 and cos 90 minus delta will be sine delta. So value of P will be equal to V1 V2 by X sine delta. Now, maximum power flow will be possible when this delta becomes equal to 0 degree. So, when delta becomes equal to 0 degree, value of power transferred in case of steady state stability limit, or that will be said as steady state stability limit of transmission line considering only series reactance, will be equal to P max equal to V1 V2 by X. This is the maximum value of steady state stability limit in case of only reactance. But as we have to consider a lossy transmission line, so the value of this maximum power flow possible through a transmission line must be less than this amount or this magnitude. Hence, in case of lossy transmission line, the steady state stability limit or the maximum value of power flow possible will be less than this value. Hence, the answer will be, the steady state stability limit of transmission line will be less than V1 V2 by X. So, the correct option that satisfies our answer is B. Okay.